ammeter voltmeter method means that okay ammeter is connected on supply side and voltmeter placed across the load, right? Voltmeter is placed across the load. Clear all of you? Yeah, anyway, just you can draw the circuit. So ammeter is a device always connected in series to load, right? Or connected in series, right? But voltmeter is a device always connected in parallel to load. Okay, voltmeter is a device always connected in parallel to load. Yeah, the load resistance RL load resistance is RL remains same. Fine. Okay, voltage across load VL voltage across load is VL, right? Load resistance remains same, therefore I think true power remains same. What is the true power consumed by load? VL into IL. The true power consumed by load VL into IL. Yes, you can write it. True power is equal VL into IL. Okay, clear? But anyway, already we told you, ideally ammeter resistance is zero. But practically not possible. Right, similarly voltmeter resistance is RV. Ideally voltmeter resistance is infinite, right? But not possible practically. Current flowing through voltmeter IV, current flowing through ammeter is IA. Okay, yeah, supply, considering DC supply. Okay, considering DC supply. Fine. Please tell me true power is equal to VL into IL, right? True power is equal to VL into IL. Yeah, just look at, but what is the measured power? Measured power is equal to voltmeter reading multiplied with ammeter reading. Voltmeter reading is multiplied with ammeter reading, right? But anyway, just here you can apply KCL. Okay, right, if you are applying KCL here, what happened, tell me, at this dot point ammeter current IA is equal to IL plus IV. Ammeter current IA is equal to IL plus IV. Okay, but what is the measured power, tell me? Measured power is equal to, just look at, measured power is equal to voltmeter reading multiplied with ammeter reading. What is a voltmeter reading? Can you say? What is a voltmeter reading? Voltmeter directly placed across the load. Voltmeter directly placed across the load. So voltmeter reading is VL. Fine. Voltmeter reading is VL. Okay. But what about ammeter reading? Ammeter reading is IA. So VL into IA. Fine. But what you can write here, IA is equal to IL plus IV. So IA is equal. Fine. IA is equal to IL plus IV. So VL into IL plus IV. Right. Simple mathematical analysis only. Therefore, measured power is equal to okay, VL IL plus VL into IV. VL into IV. But what is this IV? IV is the current flowing through voltmeter. Can we write like this? IV is the current flowing through voltmeter. IV is equal to voltmeter reading is VL. VL upon RV. Right? We can write it simply. IV is equal to VL upon RV. Right? In the next step, if you are writing here, just look at measured power is equal to, fine, VLIL is called true power plus VL into this IV is equal, you can write it VL upon RV. Okay. Right. This IV is equal, we can write it simply VL upon RV. So, can we write like this? Measured power is equal to true power plus VL square upon RV. Again, what you are observing, tell me all of you. Here also, it is not only measuring the true power. Right? Here also, if you are observing here, look at here. Not only measuring true power, but also includes the power loss in voltmeter. Also includes the power loss in voltmeter. Okay. Therefore, can we write like this? Look at all of you. Fine. not only measuring the true power, but also includes power loss in voltmeter. Right. But why it is introducing power loss in voltmeter? Because the voltmeter is connected on load side. Voltmeter is connected on load side. Okay. Tell me, but what is the error? Yeah, can we write like this? Error is equal to right. Error is equal to tell me, what is the error? Error is nothing but the deviation of measured value from its true value. The deviation of measured value from its true value. Can you say here? Please tell me. Error is equal to PM minus PT. PM minus PT. But what is PM minus PT? Tell me. All of you, please tell me. What is PM minus PT? So, can we write like this? Look at here. Error is equal to PM minus PT is equal to VL square upon RV. VL square upon RV. Therefore, here not only measuring true power, but also includes the power loss in voltmeter. Again, the producer error is positive. But what is the significance of positive error? Producer error positive, right? Can we write like this? PM greater than PT. Producer error positive, that signifies that measured power greater than that of true power, right? But what is the percentage error? Percentage error is equal, right, PM minus PT upon PT into 100. Therefore, you can write like this, right? But what is PM minus PT? VL square upon RV. VL square upon RV. Right. But what is the true power? VLIL into 100. Yes, you observe here, all of you. If you are observing here, this VL square, VL cancel. But VL upon RV, VL upon RV, what you can write it, tell me. VL upon RV is equal, can we write IV? Look at all of you. Right, VL upon RV is nothing but, right, this IV, VL upon RV is nothing but IV. You can write IV. IV upon IL into 100. This is the percentage error. Okay, right. So this is one type of notation. Right, in another way, how we can express in another way, just look at all of you. Right, in another way, just we can express like this. Percentage error is equal to VL upon RV, just you written as IV. In other words, VL upon IL. What is VL upon IL? RL. Right? Upon RV. VL upon IL. VL upon IL is nothing but RL upon RV into 100. Okay, clear all of you? Right? But again, tell me, what you are observing here? Ideally, voltmeter resistance is infinite. Okay? Ideally, right, ideally, voltmeter resistance is infinite. Whenever if it is infinite, 1 by infinity, error will be 0. But is it possible practically? No. Ideally, voltmeter resistance infinite. Infinite means simply open circuit only. Infinite means open circuit, no current flowing through the meter. If there is no current flowing through the meter, meter will give any reading? No. Right, that is the reason I can't make it infinite. I will try to design as large as possible. I will try to design as large as possible. But that is related to manufacturer. Therefore, that is related to manufacturer. Yeah, please tell me. Suppose if RV will be infinite, error will be 0. But if I am selecting, that means if the manufacturer is design. Look at all of you. If the manufacturer is design a large value of resistance, whenever large value of resistance, obviously the error is lesser. Right. Again, this is related to manufacturer only. Right. But in our hand, what we are having? Selection of RL. Load resistance is our choice only. Customer choice only. Therefore, whenever RL value is lesser, load resistance is lesser, obviously, the produced error is lesser. The produced error is lesser. Okay, fine. Therefore, that is the reason. Please tell me, all of you, ammeter, voltmeter method. Look at ammeter, voltmeter method is best suitable for, right? Is best suitable for measurement of power in a low resistive loads. Measurement of power in a low resistive loads. Right? Whenever the load resistance is lesser, what about load current is large? Load current is large. Therefore, low resistive load or large load current. Large load current. Understood? Low resistive load or large load current. Clear? Therefore, but can you say here, look at all of you. Right. Ideally, voltmeter resistance infinite. But I can't make it infinite. But I will try to design as large as possible. Therefore, the error can be reduced. That is the reason, right, loading effect can be reduced by selecting large value of voltmeter resistance. Or in other words, but what is the exact definition of loading effect? Look at here. Right. Just look at. Ammeter voltmeter method is best suitable for measurement of power in a low resistive load or large load current. Low resistive load or large load current. Comma. Produced error is positive. Produced error is positive. Understood? Okay. So produced error is positive because of voltmeter. Produced error is positive. So that indicates PM greater than PT. Right, but why this produced error is positive? Because of voltmeter. Voltmeter connected on load side. Okay. Ideally, right, ideally, voltmeter resistance is infinite. right, ideally voltmeter resistance infinite, but practically not possible. Practically not possible. So error is introduced because of load side instrument. Error is introduced because of load side instrument. Right. That is the reason this is known as loading effect of voltmeter. But in both the methods, what you observed? Right. In VA method, error is introduced because of ammeter connected on load side. Okay. In AV method, error is introduced because of voltmeter again connected on load side. In both the methods, the load side instrument is introducing the error. That is the reason, right, that is called as loading effect of ammeter. Here in this method, this is called as loading effect of voltmeter, right? But tell me, all of you, can you eliminate the loading effect? No, I can't eliminate. Why? I can't make it infinite resistance. Right, I will try to design as large as possible. I will try to design as large as possible, right? But anyway, here also to reduce the loading effect, right? To reduce the loading effect, what you are doing, look at all of you, to reduce the loading effect, we are going to select high sensitive voltmeter. We are going to select high sensitive voltmeter. But what is the meaning of high sensitive voltmeter? What is the significance of sensitivity? Right, we are going to discuss. What is sensitivity? Right, we are going to discuss. But generally, we can write like this. Sensitivity, right, is equal, or sensitivity of voltmeter is equal. Okay, sensitivity of voltmeter is equal. What you can write it? Look at all of you. Yeah, sensitivity of voltmeter is equal Rm upon VFSD. Ohms per volt. Rm upon VFSD. Ohms per volt. Yeah, all of you observe clearly. Rm upon VFSD. Ohms per volt. But how I am writing Rm upon VFSD? Right, just we are going to observe it, no issue. Right, okay. Therefore, look at here, all of you. Yeah, if I am selecting, right, if I am selecting high sensitive voltmeter, right, whenever if I am selecting high sensitive voltmeter, the meter resistance is high. By selecting large value of resistance, by selecting large value of resistance, error can be reduced. Right, so that is the reason by selecting high sensitive voltmeter, automatically resistance is large. Voltmeter resistance Rm or Rv. Right, so whenever voltmeter resistance is large, the error is lesser. So please remember, what is the significance of sensitivity? By selecting high sensitive voltmeter, right, we can reduce the loading effect of voltmeter. Okay, so error can be minimized, so automatically the loading effect of voltmeter can be minimized. So for that, we can see one numerical problem also. We can select two different meters, right? Second question, we can solve it by selecting two different meters, right? Two different meters, one is having lesser sensitivity, another meter is having higher sensitivity. Therefore, by selecting high sensitive voltmeter, definitely we can able to reduce the loading effect, right? This is the concept. Based on this concept, we can see the numerical problem so that you can understand better way. Understood? But please remember, all of you, sensitivity, right, given by, right, at the time of design, the sensitivity is mentioned by manufacturer. Sensitivity is always expressed in terms of ohms per volt. So the sensitivity of voltmeter is equal to Rm upon VFSD ohms per volt. Okay, fine. Yeah, so anyway, any problem, just we can take one small note also, right? Any problem, if you are solving, right, in all problems, okay, right, any problem, if you are solving, in all problems, whenever sensitivity is given, directly, you must calculate meter resistance, or blindly, whenever sensitivity is given in all problems blindly, first you should calculate meter resistance, then proceed the problem. So what is the meter resistance? Tell me. The meter resistance Rm is equal to sensitivity of voltmeter into V FSD, right? So just you remember this one in all problems. Just you can proceed like this. Okay. Right. Yeah. Okay. Just now we have seen the loading effect of ammeter as well as the loading effect of voltmeter. Yeah, that is the first question. Okay, we observed. Right. I told you already, right, based on that concept, right, we have taken one more good numerical problem. Just look at, right, you may be knowing all these things, but so the concept, once your concept will be clear, right, you can able to solve any type of question. Okay, yeah, just look at here. For the circuit shown in below figure, find the error in the measurement of voltage across R2, right, across R2. Okay, fine. Just look at here. Right, voltmeter A. Right, voltmeter A has a sensitivity of, voltmeter A has a sensitivity of how much? 1 kilo ohms per volt. Right, similarly, voltmeter B has a sensitivity of 20 kilo ohms per volt. Right, already we told you, in any problem, whenever sensitivity is given blindly, first of all, you should calculate meter resistance. But tell me, a 30 volts DC supply, right? 30 volts DC supply, right? R1, 5 kilo ohms, R2, 5 kilo ohms, right? Both R1 and R2 are connected series. I want to measure the voltage across R2. Both the meters are used as a range. How much range, tell me? 0 to 20 volts, full scale deflection range. 0 to 20 volts, full scale deflection range. Okay. Right. Voltmeter is connected across R2 resistor. Voltmeter is connected across R2 resistor. Okay, fine. Now, can you solve this question? Right. If you are going to observe that, what I told you, right, in all problems, first of all, look at, clear. In all problems, what do you have to take it? Right. So first, voltmeter A. What is voltmeter A? Tell me. Right. A meter sensitivity. How much sensitivity? Please tell me. Voltmeter A sensitivity is given as 1 kilo ohm per volt. 1 kilo ohm per volt. Right. 1 kilo ohm per volt. But what is the full scale value? 20 volts. The full scale value is 20 volts. Fine. Right. Whenever the full scale value is 20 volts, just look at. Okay. Full scale value is 20 volts. Right. So, voltmeter A. Now, sensitivity is equal to, right, Rm by VFSD. Clear? Rm by VFSD. Can we write like this simply? Rm is equal to sensitivity of voltmeter into VFSD. Right. Use this equation. You know already this one. If you are using this equation, what you will get? Tell me. Sensitivity is how much given? 1 kilo ohm per volt. Right, A meter sensitivity or RMA, you can take here, RMA. Right, sensitivity of A meter, RMA. RMA is equal to, right, just look at, 1 kilo ohm per volt. Okay. 1 kilo ohm per volt. Right, into, what is the full scale value? 20 volts. Full scale value, 20 volts. Okay, fine. Therefore, what you will get, tell me? The meter resistance, RMA, is equal to, okay, meter resistance, RMA, is equal to, Right, I think. Kilo ohms. Yeah, just you remember this one. Meter resistance RMA is equal to 20 kilo ohms. But in all problems, whenever voltmeter is there, right? Voltmeter, right? Internally consists of simple copper coil only. In all problems, while you are doing mathematical analysis, right? Meter always must be replaced with equivalent meter resistance. Voltmeter is replaced with equivalent meter resistance. What is the equivalent meter resistance? 20 kilo ohms. The equivalent meter resistance is 20 kilo ohms, right? Anyway, this is case 1, suppose, right? What is case 1? Tell me. Case 1, right? So, voltmeter resistance in case 1, the meter resistance RMA is equal to 20 kilo ohms, right? RMA is equal to 20 kilo ohms. But anyway, here only, if you are doing, suppose, ideal condition, how is it, right? And practical condition, how is it? This is a practical value, right? So therefore, RMA is equal to 20 kilo ohms. Now, in the same problem, right, or in the same circuit, just redraw the circuit. Okay, if I'm redrawing the circuit, how is it? Tell me. Right. So this is R1, 5 kilo ohms, R2, 5 kilo ohms. Supply is how much? 30 volts. 30 volts. Voltmeter, where it is connected? Voltmeter is connected across R2. But already I told you, this voltmeter, right? Already I told you, this voltmeter simply replaced with equivalent meter resistance only. Understood, all of you? whatever this voltmeter is there, look at, this is your voltmeter. This is replaced with equivalent meter resistance only. Right? Understood? It must be replaced with equivalent meter resistance only. Right? Therefore, whenever if I replace it with equivalent meter resistance, how is it? Tell me. It's like this. What is the RMA? This one RMA. How much? 20 kilo ohms. This RMA is 20 kilo ohms. Clear? Tell me. RMA 20 kilo ohms. How is it? Mathematically, if you are analyzing R2 parallel with RMA, right? R2 parallel with RMA. Once again, you can redraw it, or otherwise, you can also change here only. R2 parallel with RMA. Okay, can I write here? If I am writing here, R2 parallel with RMA, how is it? This is 30 volts. 5 kilo ohms. This is R1. What about this one? R2 parallel with RMA. Right, R2 parallel with RMA. Okay. Therefore, now please tell me. Right, R2 parallel with RMA. I want to measure the voltage across here. Right, voltage across here is nothing but VMA. Okay, voltage across here is nothing but VMA. Clear? But what is R2 parallel with RMA? Solve it, all of you. R2 parallel with RMA. If you are going to observe here, look at. Right, 5 kilo ohms parallel with 20 kilo ohms. What you can write it? So 5k into 20k upon 5k plus 20k. Right, simplify it. right? This is 25k. 5 5s are 25, 5 4s are. So therefore, how much tell me? R2 parallel with Rm is nothing but 4 kilo ohms. You check it all of your calculation part. Right, this is 25, 5 5s are 25, 5 4s are. Okay, so 4 kilo ohms. Now, can I write here 4 kilo ohms? Okay. Now, apply voltage divider rule. If you are applying voltage divider rule, what you will get, tell me? Voltage across this 4k ohms, voltage across R2 parallel with RMA, VMA is equal to, what you can write it? Apply voltage divider rule, right? 30 volts into, 30 volts into, right? Understood all of you? So, 30 volts into 4k upon 4k plus 5k. Simple voltage divider rule only. V2 is equal to supply voltage Vs into R2 upon R1 plus R2, like that. Okay, so 30 into 4k upon 4k plus 5k, right? Simplify this one. 4 upon 9k, right? KK cancel only, right? 120 by 9, right? 120 by 9 is how much, tell me? So if you are calculating here, 120 by 9, how much this value? 13.33, right? 13.33, right? Is it clear? Check this value, 13.33 volts. Please tell me, whatever you got, this 13.33 volts, right? Is it measured value or true value? Right, whatever you got this reading, 13.33 is a measured value or true value? Right, obviously it is a measured value. Why? It is a practical meter. Practical distance 20 kilo ohms. Therefore, this is called measured value. Okay? Right, this is called measured value. Clear all of you? Right, this 13.33, right, is called measured value. That is called VMA, is a measured value. Okay, but practically how is it? Right, whenever if you are considering ideal condition, how is the ideal condition, tell me? Right, you may be knowing very well, ideally. Right, ideally the meter resistance Rm is infinite. Whenever the meter resistance Rm is infinite, right, what happened, tell me? So simply apply voltage divider rule only. Reason, R2 parallel with Rm. Right, R2 parallel with Rm. Right, 5 kilo ohms is parallel with infinite. Right, it's nothing but 5 kilo ohms only. Okay, 5 kilo ohms is parallel with infinite, is nothing but 5 kilo ohms only. Okay, now please tell me, if you are writing here directly, just you can apply voltage divider rule. Right, if you are applying voltage divider rule, what you will get? Just 5k. This is 5k, this is R1, it is R2, this is 30 volts. Therefore, now apply voltage divider rule. Whenever if you are applying voltage divider rule, output voltage Vm is equal to, right, output voltage Vm is equal to, what you can write it? This is your Vm, right? Vm is equal to 30 volts into 5k upon 5k plus 5k. Understood? Right, 30 volts into 5k upon 5k plus 5k. Apply again voltage divider rule only. Therefore, 5 upon 10, right? 10 cancel. 5 3 is 15. How much? 15 volts. But tell me, whatever you got this 15 volts, what is this value? Whatever you got this 15 volts, this is called true value, Vt. Why true value? Tell me, is it true or measured? True value. Why it is called true value? Can you say? Right, why it is called true value? Ideal condition. But ideal meter, will it exist? Ideal meter, will it exist practically? No, it's never possible. Ideal meter never exists, right? So, but theoretically we are solving this one. Therefore, the true reading is 15 volts. But what is the measured value? 13.33 volts. Okay, right, the measured value, right, this is measured value, right? So 13.33 volts VMA. Measured value 13.33, true value 15 volts. Obviously, error is introduced, right? Obviously, error is introduced. But how to calculate error? Tell me, right? Error is equal, or percentage error is equal. What you can write it? You observe, all of you. Percentage error is equal measured minus true VMA, right? Minus VT upon VT into 100. How much? Tell me. 13.33, right, minus 15 volts upon 15 volts into 100, right, into 100. Simplify, all of you. Right, once you are simplifying, how much you are going to get it? Tell me. Do this simple calculation. Right, once you are done the simple calculation, how much you are going to get it? Right, I think minus 11.13. Right, minus 11.13. Okay, percentage. Please tell me, whenever if you are writing minus 11.13 percentage, what you are observing here, look at all of you. The produced error is negative. Produced error is negative. But what is the significance of negative error? The significance of negative error, measured value VMA always less than that of true value. That means you never get true value. You never get ideal condition. Look at all of you. Whenever if voltmeter resistance, whenever if voltmeter resistance is infinite, if voltmeter resistance is infinite, you will get a true value of 15 volts. Right, but it's never possible. Infinite. I can't make it infinite. I will try to design as large as possible. I will try to design as large as possible. Therefore, right, error is how much? 11.13. This is the magnitude of error. Negative sign indicates that measured value less than that of true value. Right, if you want to calculate accuracy, if you want to calculate accuracy, what is accuracy? Tell me. Accuracy is equal, percentage accuracy is equal 100 minus this error, right? 100 minus error, 100 minus of this error. So please tell me, 100 minus error is how much? 11.13 percentage. Okay, error is 11.13 percentage. You take only magnitude. You take only magnitude. Why? Because already I told you, negative sign indicates that measured value less than that of true value. Therefore, right, how much error tell me? How much accuracy tell me? 100 minus of this one, obviously 88.7. 100 minus 10, 90. Right. So 1.13. 90 minus 1.13. Obviously 88.7 percentage. Right, 88.7 percentage. This is the right. This is the accuracy. Understood? 88.7 percentage is the accuracy. right, 88.7%. This is the right, this is the accuracy. Understood? 88.7% is the accuracy. Right, A meter accuracy is this much. B meter has a sensitivity of, clear all of you? Right, I can select like this. Full scale voltage 20 volts remains same. Both the meters are having 20 volts only. Right, B meter sensitivity 20 kilo ohms per volt. But you know already. Right, what do you know? Right, RMB is equal to sensitivity of B meter into VFSD. Sensitivity of B meter into VFSD. Therefore, can we write like this? What is the sensitivity of B meter? 20 kilo ohms per volt into 20 kilo ohms per volt into VFSD is how much? 20 volts. Therefore, 20 into 20, 400. Right, so RMB is equal 400 kilo ohms. Okay, but already we told you, in all problems you must replace meter is always replaced with equivalent meter resistance only. Yes or no? Meter is always replaced with equivalent meter resistance only. Please tell me. Right, meter is always replaced with equivalent meter resistance only. Look at 5 kilo ohms. Here old meter always replaced with tell me, old meter is always replaced with equivalent meter resistance only. I'm replacing directly with meter resistance. RMB is how much? RMB 400 kilo ohms, right? This is R2. Okay, right, R2 5 kilo ohms, clear? Right, okay, 30 volts. Okay, please tell me, R2 parallel with RMB, what happened? We can redraw here. Shall I redraw directly here? I want to redraw here only directly. Therefore, please tell me here. R2 parallel with RMB. Whenever R2 parallel with RMB, how much? 5K parallel with 400K. Right, 5K parallel with 400K. Okay, tell me, bolo. 5K into 400K upon 5K plus 400K. Simplify. 5K into 400K. Right. How much? 5 4s are 20, obviously 2000 upon 405. Simplified, all of you, if you have done like this, I think 4.93 kilo ohms. 4.93 kilo ohms. Okay, this is R2 parallel with RMB. Right, shall I take here only directly like this? Okay. Clear? Yeah, okay. So now, if you are observing here, R2 parallel with, okay. Look at, Okay. Here R2 parallel with RMB. Already you got it. How much tell me? 4.93 kiloohms. Clear? Yeah. Okay. Here VM. B. Fine. VMB is, you are measuring here. Therefore, VMB is equal to, what you can write it, tell me? Apply voltage divider rule again. Right, just you apply voltage divider. VMB is equal 30 volts into 30 volts into 4.93 upon 5 plus, 4.93k upon 5k plus 4.93k. Now, can you simplify this one? 30 into 4.93k upon 9.93k. Right, if you have done proper simplification, right, what is VMB? 14.89 volts. Please check this calculation. 14.89 volts, right? This is the VMB. This is the VMB. This is called measured value. Okay, understood? This is your VMB. Right, and this is called your measured value. Right, this is called measured value. But already under ideal condition, you got the true value. Right, how much true voltage, tell me? Already you got it previously. The true voltage. How much? True voltage is equal, right? So, please take this. Sorry, this is true voltage only. Right. It's like a gross error. We written VM, but it's not VM. Right. Okay. So, you know very well. This is true voltage. Why true voltage? Meter reading we calculated. Okay. But true voltage. Why? Already I mentioned so clearly. This is true value. Under ideal conditions, always you are going to get true value. Right. It's clear. Right. Under ideal conditions, you are going to get true value. You got measured value. You know true value. Therefore, can I calculate the error? Percentage error. Right. So, tell me, what is the percentage error? Percentage error is equal to measured value VMB minus VT upon VT into 100. Right, VMB minus VT upon VT into 100. What is VMB? 14.89. True value, how much? True value 15 upon 15 into 100. Yeah, simplify this value. 14.89. Clear, all of you? 14.89 minus 15 upon 15 into 100. So, the error is minus 0.73. Error is minus 0.73 percentage. Again, tell me, the produced error is negative. What is the meaning of negative error? You know very well. VM less than VT. You remember, all of you? Producer error is negative. Negative means, right, producer error is negative. Negative means measured value less than that of true value. Right. Here error is how much? Error is minus 0.73 percentage. In the previous problem, how much error is? Case 1. Previous problem is here only. Case 1. Whenever A meter is connected, what is the error, tell me? 11.13 percentage. 11.13 percent. You observe? 11.13 percentage. This is the error. Right. Obviously, A meter error is more. A meter error is more. B meter error is lesser. So, obviously, which is more accurate? B only. or you can calculate accuracy is equal to 100 minus percent error, A meter accuracy 88.7%. This is A meter accuracy. Okay. But what about B meter accuracy? Tell me. Look at, once it comes to B meter accuracy, can we write like this? Accuracy is equal to percentage accuracy is equal 100 minus percent error. Okay. 100 minus percent error. Clear? 100 minus 7.3. I mean 0.73%. Already told you so clearly. Never consider this minus sign. Minus sign indicates only produced error negative. Indicates that measured value less than that of true value. Right. While you are calculating accuracy, you should consider only magnitude. Understood? Therefore, how much tell me? 100 minus 0.73. Right. 99 point. Right. 100 minus 73. Right. 27. So, 0.73. Obviously, 99.27%. Right. Clear, all of you? Okay. So, 99.27%. This is the accuracy. So, please tell me which meter has greater accuracy? Which meter has greater accuracy? Obviously, B meter has greater accuracy. Right. Please tell me, what is the loading effect? Here the loading effect only 0.73%. B meter loading effect 0.73% only. But A meter loading effect 11.13%. Right? Okay. A meter loading effect 11.13%. So obviously B meter has greater accuracy. Which meter has greater accuracy? B meter has greater accuracy. Understood, all of you? B meter has greater accuracy. Right? Not only that one, you observed in both the meters. What you observed? Tell me. Right? So, by selecting sensitivity of A meter, sensitivity of A meter, right, tell me, sensitivity of A meter, 1 kilo ohm per volt. Sensitivity of B meter, 20 kilo ohm per volt. So, look at all of you, by selecting large value of, by selecting high sensitive voltmeter, look at, by selecting high sensitive voltmeter, we can reduce the loading effect. So, by selecting B meter, the loading effect is only 0.73%, corresponding accuracy 99.27%, right? But sensitivity of A meter is lesser. So, therefore, loading effect is how much? 11.13%. Accuracy is also lesser, something 88.7%. So, obviously, compared to A meter, B meter has greater accuracy. Right? Once again, I am repeating. Compared to A meter, B meter has greater accuracy. So, sensitivity plays an important role. Sensitivity of the meter plays an important role. I think all of you clear this concept. So, significance of sensitivity in all practical labs, in all industries. Right, while you are going to do the measurement, always you try to select high sensitive voltmeter so that loading effect is reduced, so that accuracy of the instrument is very high or good. Okay, right, I think all of you understood. I hope it's so clear. Okay.